All right, everyone out there following me drinking across America, Ron Antonori coming at you with another episode from Nonic Beer Bar and Kitchen in beautiful uptown Columbus, Georgia. It is March 25th, so you know what that means? It is Happy Oberon Day. That's right, we are celebrating it out here. We have got the Oberon Ale right here. And this is one of my signature drinks from Oberon Brewing Company. It is a wheat ale fermented with their signature blend of house yeast ale yeast, mixing a spicy hop character with mildly fruity aromas. You can definitely smell the scent, orange flavored. I like to tell people, you know, if they like Blue Moon or something along that line, Shock Top, you know, the big two, they want to try to put out some orange flavored ales and all, that if you want a real craft version of it, go with the Oberon Ale. Perfect complement. Addition to the wheat malt, and it's a smooth mouthfeel. Perfect beer for summertime. I say, you know, you can definitely smell the orange peel and the spices in it. Great summertime beer. Comes in at 5.8% ABV, so pretty normal for the wheat ales. Oh yeah, and to think this beer is only made with 4 ingredients, and none of them are spices or fruit, but you definitely smell spice, and you smell fruit, and it's all from the hops that are in it. So, you know, it's a nice hazy kind of an orange, definitely reminds you of summertime by looking at it. It goes down very smooth. Very smooth for 5.8%. You definitely sit around and drink a few of them. They've actually got another one. It's a mango habanero Oberon. So it's the same beer brewed with mangoes and habanero. I'm going to be drinking that one next, giving my view of it. Because, you know, I love those mango habanero beers. I love something with a little spice, a little flavor to it. So definitely going to be trying that one as soon as I get this one down. Hoping to snatch up a little Oberon swag, talk to a few people, hopefully get their point of view on these. Coming back at you throughout the afternoon right here at Nonic Beer Bar and Kitchen in uptown Columbus, Georgia. So all you drinkers across America, raise a pint of Oberon today. It is National Oberon Day. Until I come back, salute. All right, all you drinkers across America, I'm back at you, man. I still got some of this 10-ounce pour of Oberon Ale. Still working on it. You know, I hope you're enjoying your favorite Oberon this afternoon. Like I said, man, March 25th, it is National Oberon Day. So if you're not drinking Oberon, you definitely need to this afternoon. Beautiful day down here in Georgia. You know, it's in the 70s. It feels like summertime. Seems like we just bypassed spring altogether and went from winter to summer, which, hey, is fine with me. Coming from West Palm Beach, Florida, where it's warm year-round, I prefer this kind of weather. Great beer. Great place to be drinking now. You know, go ahead. Come on down. Come on out. Let's enjoy an Oberon together, guys. You know, I happened to miss out Friday night here at Nonic Beer Bar and Kitchen. They had their The Juice Strikes Back. I'm going to show you see if we can get focused in here. Yeah. The Juice Strikes Back, featuring 18 hazy IPAs, fruited sours, pastry stouts, never before available in Georgia. I see that there's several of them left available up there on the beer board. So once I try these Oberons, I'm going to jump in and try some of these hazy IPAs and, you know, whatever they've got left from Friday afternoon, Friday evening. I'm going to try as many of them as I can. I'm seeing probably at least 4 or 5 of them right now that I'm definitely going to jump on as soon as I get a chance.
Get some Oberon swag?
Oh, yeah, man. I appreciate it.
Yeah, man. Thanks for coming out.
Thank you. Yeah, man, I got some of that great Oberon swag I was telling you about. Pins, stickers, some Oberon shades, man. I'm definitely going to be sporting them when I'm out and about. Another koozie to add to my collection. Hey, man. and always got the koozies, keychain, bottle opener. Being a bartender, man, you can never have too many of these on your keychain. So, man, I'm going to be enjoying my Oberon. This is the ale. I'm going to be finishing it up. Then I'm going to come back at you, telling you all about the Mango Habanero Oberon. And then, of course, trying some of those hazy IPAs and stouts that are available that are left over from Friday night. So I'm excited about this afternoon. We're going to be drinking beer. We're going to be talking, hanging out, having a blast. So if you're anywhere in Columbus, Georgia, come on down and join me. All right, everyone, Drinking Across America. Follow me, Ron Antinori, at Drinking Across America. I'm back at you from Nonick Beer Bar and Kitchen in beautiful uptown Columbus, Georgia, on this beautiful Oberon Day, March 25th, 2019. And I have got right now Bell's Brewing Mango Habanero Oberon. It is brewed with the same exact four ingredients that the regular Oberon wheat ale is brewed with. Only difference is you've got pureed mango and habanero peppers added to it during fermentation. So it's definitely got a full-bodied, full-flavored, medium-bodied wheat malt. Yeah. You can smell the mango. A little bit of the habanero. It comes in at 5.8%, just like the regular Oberon wheat ale does. You know, it is only it is a limited variation, and it is brewed at the original brewery in Kalamazoo, Michigan, and it is only available in draft. So that's the way it comes, man. Draft beer, 20 ounces, man. Not a pint, man. We don't play with no pints. We go 20 ounces. Go big or go home. And that's the way we're going to bring it to you all afternoon long, right here at Nonick Beer Bar and Kitchen. We're going to go ahead and give it the ultimate taste test and see how the Mango Habanero stands up to the original Oberon. Mmm. Oh, yeah. I mean, as soon as it hits your mouth, the habanero takes over. Very spicy beer. Not complaining. I like it. Personally, I love it. You know, when I was down in West Palm Beach, one of the local breweries down there, oh man, brain fart. Can't remember the name of the brewery now, but I'll remember it sooner or later. But they came out with a chocolate habanero. Chocolate jalapeno beer, actually. And it was very, very pepper pronounced, just like this. Excuse me. Not bad manners, just damn good beer, guys. And all of you out there that follow me know that for a fact. I like it. I mean, it's not much of a mango to it. Definitely a lot more of the habanero, which to me is a good thing. Like I said, man, I love spicy. I love something with some flavor to it. You know, yeah, just a good old beer is good every now and then. But if you're drinking craft beer, you're drinking craft beer for the flavor. You're not just drinking it to get drunk. You're drinking it because you like the flavors. You like to have a beer that is flavorful. This is a very flavorful, medium-bodied ale. Like I said, as soon as it hits your mouth, you're gonna feel the habanero. And it's not a whole lot of heat, but it's just enough so that you know that the habaneros are there. And I'm still tasting the habaneros. They know what they're doing at Bell's Brewing Company up in Kalamazoo, Michigan. Let me tell you, man, those guys know what they're doing in brewing some beer. To add just the perfect blend of mango and habanero, man, this is perfect. I can drink this all day long on a summer day, spring day, fall day. Hell, even in the wintertime, man, you know, the little habanero, it would definitely warm you up. You don't think of drinking ales in the wintertime when it's hot, when it's cold out, I mean. But the habanero flavor warms you up. It's got a great flavor to it. Oh, man. That's perfect. It's got that nice little spice that hits the back of your throat. Ah. This is a good beer, man. And at only 5.8% alcohol, it's definitely one that you can drink more than one or two of and still be comfortable to be able to walk home, drive home, you know, function. And, you know, that's the big thing, you know. Yes, I'm out drinking all across America. You know, I love to go out. I love to drink my beers. But the thing is, drink in moderation, people. You know, that's why we have these craft beers. You know, people that drink craft beers, we're not out there to get drunk and get slammed on them. No, we're out there drinking the beers for the flavor, for the experience, for the camaraderie, for the friendship that you build with people that you are, that you meet at the breweries, at the bars, you know. Go out, have a beer, enjoy yourself, you know. I'm going to. I'm going to finish up this one. I'll be back before I finish it, you know. Always giving you my little thoughts of things that come to my head when I'm sitting out here drinking, you know. Because I like to drink, and I like to think. And I hope that you do, too. So, Drinking Across America, we're coming back at you on National Oberon Day from Milling Beer Bar and Kitchen. Drinkers Across America, man. I am back at you at Noni Beer Bar and Kitchen here in beautiful uptown Columbus, Georgia. We're going to have Jason from, you know, the local rep from Bell's Brewery is going to be coming over here, joining us here shortly, talking about everything that's going on today, you know, about their beers, about the specials, you know, Oberon Day. So I'm very excited about talking to him, getting him on camera, getting his point of view of everything. You know, plenty of swag here, man. There's plenty left out here. And, you know, we're just getting started this afternoon, man. There's glasses. You buy a 20-ounce Oberon, you get to keep the glass. You know, so you got this beautiful Bell's Brewing Company glass to go along with your beer. We've got hats. Yeah. Come out and get your hats while they last. Match boxes for those that still collect the matches. A little bit of Oberon flavored lip balm. And we've got the Oberon tattoo. Stickers. Can't go enough stickers, man. You know, the car is getting loaded up with stickers from all these breweries that I go to. And of course, you know, I love my koozies, man. Gotta keep those beers cold. And also, the Oberon official keychain bottle opener. So, all my friends and fans out there, man, come on down, enjoy the day, enjoy some beers, let's make it happen.
No, about that. Oh,
yeah. All right, everyone, Drinking Across America. Ron Antonari coming back at you with Jason.
Jason.
He's the local rep for Bell's Brewing Company.
Allegedly.
Yes, allegedly. That's what he claims he does. Anyhow.
They give me a paycheck.
All I think he works for is the free beer, but, you know, hey, who wouldn't?
Well, someone's paying for it.
Yeah. So tell the people, if they're not too familiar with it, a little bit about Bell's Brewing.
Bell's Brewing, long story. I always say two things. We were trapped here before it was cool, and we're probably your favorite brewery's favorite brewery.
Yeah.
Started brewing beer in 1985. Legally. I think Larry Bell, the owner, founder, still president to this day, in Kalamazoo, Michigan, started baking bread. And if you know anything about brewing or bread making, they're really similar.
Yeah.
Really similar.
Yeah.
So he got into yeast propagation and really just fell in love with the process.
Yeah, process of turning the bread into beer.
And bread, beer innately is liquid bread.
Yeah.
And, you know, still 100% family owned and independent.
That's cool.
Brewing.
After all these years,
100%. There's no investors. Not one. So when we succeed, or, you know, when we have a, you know, product that's like, this may have not necessarily worked out that how we thought, like, we have the ability to do that and not have the shareholders be like, oh, this didn't turn a profit. So now we have grown from the first brew pub in Michigan in 1985 to the seventh largest craft brewery in the nation. Grown a ton of beer, still, I say only in 40 states, but we're only in 40 states, being a brewery that's, you know, 33, 33, 34. My math is terrible. That's not. That's why
it's in the 30s.
That's why I sell beer. I'm not a bad.
Yeah, exactly. Just like, I don't want to have to think about numbers. I just want to drink.
And we try to brew beer that's approachable on both aspects of you know, being complex in its simplicity of, you know, appealing to someone who just started drinking beer, or you know, a hophead that, you know, needs his next fix. Can appreciate it too hard. And this is almost what today's for. We're at Nautic in Columbus, Georgia, and it's Oberon Day.
The perfect beer bar in Columbus, and Oberon Day.
Oberon Day.
Like we said, man, it is Oberon Day. There we go.
Yes.
Got the shirt, got the hat.
Yeah. And Oberon's very special beer for us. I forget what year we started brewing Oberon, but that was actually called Soul Sun.
Soul Sun?
Soul Sun.
Okay.
Before it was called Oberon.
And where did the name Oberon come from?
A few different reasons. We got a cease and desist from Seoul.
that would usually do it.
Sure. What we had already was a following with that beer, and it's a six-letter word, and the logo has always been the same. So the sun's always been there.
Okay.
But we needed this. We didn't. The brewery in itself didn't have a whole lot of money, so we're like, oh, well, how do we change all this marketing terms and aspects? So let's keep another six-letter word in, and just change the wording and have a word that's also fun to say. Hey, give me an Oberon. Give me, like, it is a funky word to say.
Yeah.
But also, just like almost every beer in the Belt portfolio, there's a story to it. So Oberon is the king of the fairies. There's King Fairy, King Oberon in A Midsummer Night Dream, which was Shakespeare.
Shakespeare, Mary Bell, and you literary.
Yes, and Mary Bell is a huge fan of writing poetry and stories between Shakespeare and Hemingway, which in essence was the story behind
Hemingway. Hemingway loved his drinking, so I mean.
And, and, you know, the Two-Hearted River. Yeah, 100%. That took me too long to get. So we're a brewery that's, you know, staying true to our roots and brewing beer, have a good time and have multiple love, which is sometimes it's like, hey, let's and, you know, really having those styles that, you know, lean towards that.
And that's what beer is about, man, just getting together with your friends and even with strangers.
What are we doing here?
You're out at a bar. Exactly. It's like, and that's what it's all about, man. You go out, you're drinking, you're meeting people, and it's all about, you know, the friendship that you earn from people. You meet them, you drink some beer. I mean, it brings people together.
It does.
If more people around the world would drink beer, they'd be less war.
That's accurate.
Beer for peace.
Yes.
Cheers. Cheers.
I appreciate you coming out today, man.
Oh, man. Anytime I can, man. I mean, I love the beer. I love the brewery. Oberon was one of our top sellers at the bar that I work at right down the street.
I hear that a lot of... This is one of our better sellers, or this is the one of the beers that got me into beer, or, you know,
I like to try to, if people are into just the big three, I'll ask them, you know, well, what do you usually drink?
Sure.
And they'll say, you know, I drink Bud Light, or I drink Mick Ultra, or I'll like Blue Moon. Well, if you like
I'll
Blue Moon,
those
if
beers.
You like Blue Moon, you'll definitely love the regular Oberon. Because, I mean, it's not brewed with any of the oranges. No of the spices. It's only got four ingredients. I'm not sure what the four are, but I'm sure this man right here probably knows. Not off the top of his head, because I just put him on the spot.
Yeast, malt, water.
That's it. Exactly.
That's all it takes, man.
That's all it takes to make a good beer. And you can make it flavorful, just like the Oberon. And if someone that likes Blue Moon or Shock Top recommend the Oberon, I guarantee they're going to love it. I'm going to guarantee it. Because
if you don't, that's where
you
go.
It's all on me. I'll buy your beer.
This is not endorsed by Jason and or Bell Brewery. It's not.
These are my opinions. My opinions only. But, I love it. It's like, I love the regular Oberon. I was looking forward to trying the Mango Habanero.
Mango Habanero. Is that what you're drinking
now? That's what I'm drinking now. That's my second one. I love it.
Oh, second one.
I love the habanero flavor, man. It just hits you immediately as soon as it comes. Me, I didn't taste the mango so much, which is fine with me.
Yeah.
I like that habanero. I like that little spice. I like the way it leaves a little burn on the back of your throat.
Beautiful.
And it is. It's a great beer for this time of weather. I mean, we're in the 70s right now, man. It's springtime, and acting like it's summertime.
Yeah.
What do you do? For some reason, it keeps moving. Thank God I got editing. But,
it has that heat characteristic to it, but it doesn't overtake the beer.
Yeah, exactly. It doesn't. You got that little bit of a heat which lingers, which is good, but you still taste the beer.
Sure.
You still taste that regular Oberon. The mango habanero is brewed with the same ingredients, the same four ingredients as the regular Oberon.
What was it again?
It was hops.
He's gonna forget.
Barley
malt. So
barley
yes.
Malt, wheat and water.
Yeast.
Oh man, that's right. Bread. You got to drink your beer. Now, like I've always said, man, beer is liquid food. Man can survive on beer.
Well, that's why. To get into the tangent of just the history of beer, that's what farmhouse ales. Were to the farmers when the water wasn't good enough to drink. So you can't survive.
Yeah, you can't. Man can survive on beer alone.
This is
If it's good beer.
This is the excuses we give ourselves to.
We keep telling ourselves that. That way we can continue drinking and feel good about it. You know? And, I love everything I've had from Bellsburg before, which I've had the Oberon, and I've had the mango, I've had the official
brand IPA.
It was brought down to my bar. I got to sample some of it. I'm hoping that we start carrying it as well. Does it come out on draft?
Because yes,
that's one
draft.
Good.
Any package you get too hard in, you can find a fish. It's going to be year-round. You're never going to have an issue with it. It's always going to be available. So 100% you can purchase it at his bar or at your local.
Because I'm a big draft drinker. And as long as I can drink draft beer, you know, I'm not much on the bottles, cans, anything like that. I like that. That's the way beer was supposed to be made. Beer was made to be drank out of the draft. Not bottled, not to be drank a month or two afterwards. Drink it as fresh as possible, and you got all the flavor. And, you know, because, you know, people don't think about, you know, people just think, well, alcohol, beer, wine, you know, it gets better with age. Not so much. Beer isn't that way. Wine is, but beer, it does have a shelf life, and it's usually 3 to 6 months, depending on the brewers. I like to try to get mine as fresh as possible.
Especially the hop forward beers, yeah, please drink them. Yeah. Don't age.
This mango habanero, a little bit about it. How often, is this brand new? Did y'all just start brewing it, or?
We brewed it for a while. But, you know, in these essence, we try to focus on Oberon and have almost that secondary option in a situation like an Oberon launch party at Nonic in Columbus. Yeah. I'll be here until
all night.
Well, hotel room, safety first.
Midnight. Yeah, exactly. At least there's some in walking distance. So
the shirts. Yeah. I will come see y'all soon. See, there's people here that are. I will come talk to y'all soon. Sorry, y'all.
That's what we're here for.
So, we don't get much like the variant kegs in this bay. We try to make a thank you to accounts that are going above and beyond in certain situations. It's you know, mango habanero Oberon's never going to be would probably never be a year-round option.
Yeah.
But it's really just driving excitement to have more Oberon.
And how many kegs are available here in Georgia. Is there a certain amount of kegs?
Yeah, I believe we got 8 kegs in the state.
Okay. So we're lucky enough to have one of them here today.
Here at Nonic in Columbus, Georgia.
Right here.
We're over on launch day.
You want to be here?
I'll be here, like I said, until.
Yeah. I'm going to be here as long as I need. And it may be until.
Oh, man. I appreciate you talking. I mean, is there any other questions?
Yeah, I appreciate it, man. It was nice.
Yeah.
Nice meeting you.
I'm glad you got my good side, too.
Yeah. Always got to make sure it's on the good side.
Yeah. Do you have the good side?
Every side's a good side.
All right, guys, so thank you for joining us. Drinking Across America.
Yes.
Me and Jason.
Yeah.
Out here at Nodig Beer Bar and Kitchen.
In Columbus, Georgia.
Oberon Day. Uptown, Columbus, Georgia. Come check it out. Salute. Yes. All right, all you drinkers across America, follow me, Ron Antonori, at Drinking Across America. Coming back at you from Nodig Beer Bar and Kitchen in beautiful uptown Columbus, Georgia. I am now, I've done the two Oberon beers on National Oberon Day. So now I'm out here trying out some of these other beers that were left over from the Juice Strikes Back Day last Friday, March 22nd. I wasn't able to make it, but luckily they've got some of the beers left for me. And this one right here is the first of four in a flight of four because, you know, I like my flights of beer because I like to be able to sample the beers, sample as many as I can, report back to you, the drinkers across America, of what these beers are all about. So the first of four on this flight today is the Three Taverns, the Three Taverns Brewing Company Morning Snack. It is an Imperial Milk Stout. It is originally part of the Three Taverns Imagination Project. It's a morning snack was first debuted during their fourth year anniversary. And it was such a hit that they decided to bring it back again. It is a maple, bacon, banana, coffee, milk stout. So that's a hell of a lot of different flavors going on right there, man. I mean, what sold me on it, and it's probably going to sell a lot of you people, is the bacon. How many beers do you know are brewed with bacon? Me personally, none. I've never heard of that before. But I'm about to right here on Three Taverns Morning Smack. So, let's go. I mean, I can definitely smell the maple. I can smell the bacon in it. I'm going to go out on a limb before I even taste this beer and tell all of you that this is definitely one beer that drinks like a meal. I mean, what better way to start your day than with the morning smack? I mean, hell, it's got maple, it's got bacon, it's got bananas, it's got coffee, it's got milk. It's everything you want for a morning breakfast beer. So for those of you that like to wake and drink, this is probably the beer for you. It definitely comes in with a strong maple and bacon scent. It weighs in at a pretty hefty 8% ABV. So this isn't something that you're going to be able to kill several of. You're going to want to drink one or two, and it's probably just a sipping beer, like most craft beers are. But we're going to go ahead and give it the ultimate taste test. Because it does have that bacon. Oh, man, I just can't get over the maple and bacon. But let's see what it tastes like, because that's what it's all about, man. If the beer doesn't taste good, why do you want it? But we're going to go ahead and give it a shot right now. That is a surprisingly smooth stout. The bacon, the maple, those are the two pronounced flavors in this beer right here. Man, if you haven't tried it yet, you definitely want to try it. Three Taverns Brewing Company out of Decatur, Georgia, outside of Atlanta. I mean, they've got it down, man. When it comes to maple, when it comes to bacon, when it comes to beer, I mean, I'm not really tasting so much the banana. A little bit of the coffee is coming over. But those other flavors are way more pronounced than the banana.
I take that back. If you wait a few minutes, you're going to taste that banana flavor coming back on the back throat, on the back taste of it. But you definitely have a very distinct maple and bacon flavor right here. This beer is excellent. I've got to give it 2 pints up. Because if you love bacon, you love maple flavor, you love beer, and you've got to try Three Taverns Smack, Morning Smack. This beer is very smooth, and it does not seem to weigh in at a pretty hearty 8% ABV. Most 8% ABV beers are going to taste a little strong. They're going to be a little hearty. This one is very smooth. And I recommend it to anyone out there wanting to try a new kind of stout, a new kind of porter. You definitely want to give this beer a chance. Three Taverns Brewing Company, Morning Smack. So, I'm going to finish up this little taster, and I'm going to be back at you, because this is only the first of 4 in this flight of 4. So all you drinkers and all you thinkers out there across America, stay tuned, because I'm coming back right after this. All right, all my fellow drinkers across America, joining me, the Ron Antonori, as I come back at you with another episode of Drinking Across America, reporting at you from Noni Beer Bar and Kitchen in beautiful uptown Columbus, Georgia. I am on a flight of 4 this afternoon, and as you can see, it is a very good dark body stout. This one is actually the 450 North Brewing Company S'mores Stack. It is a pastry stout with marshmallow, chocolate, vanilla, and graham crackers. It is from the 450 North Brewing Company out of Columbus, Indiana. That's right, not Columbus, Georgia, where I'm at right now. Not Columbus, Ohio, Columbus, Indiana, comes up with this S'mores Stack. Smelling it, it definitely smells like a lot of s'mores. I can smell the chocolate. I can smell the marshmallow and the graham cracker in it. This beer comes in a pretty heavy 10% ABV, so it's not for you light hitters out there. I would recommend it for those of you that actually know what stouts and porters are all about and expect a little heavier beer, because they are heavier. They're drank heavier because they are brewed for cold weather. So cold weather, you want a heavier beer, more alcohol content. You want it to warm you up a little bit more. And it's pretty surprising that I'm actually going to be drinking this on a day that's like 80 degrees outside. But you know what? I do what I need to do to bring the best beers to all of you out there across America and across the world. Because I know that I've got followers, not only in the United States of America, but I've got people following me from Europe, from Russia, from Asia, and I want every one of you to know what these beers are like here in America. That way, if you ever come across them, you know what to try, you know what not to try. And of course, if you tell me where you want me to go, I will be there, because I'm all for travel, man. That's what this website is all about, bringing you the best beers all across America. And once I bring every beer from America to you, I am going, oh yeah, I'm going to start going across the continent, man, to Europe, to Asia to South America, you know, everywhere that has good beer, I'm going to bring it to you, the beer drinking public, not just across America, but all across the globe, man, because beer brings people together. Once again, this is a pastry stout with marshmallows, chocolate, vanilla, and graham cracker. So, they say that it is a liquid s'more. It definitely tastes like it. It definitely smells like it. Now, for the ultimate test, and that is the taste test. Because if the beer doesn't taste good, well, of course, that's just one man's opinion. But you let me know what you think about it. So here we go. Salute. That is actually smooth for being 10% alcohol. 10%, just think about it, man. 10% ABV is more than twice the amount of alcohol in a Bud Light. 10% alcohol, that's going to be probably 2.5 Bud Lights off of one of these. And it's smooth. It doesn't have an aftertaste. I am tasting the marshmallow on the... Oh, yeah. There goes the marshmallow. Followed by some chocolate. I personally do not taste the graham cracker crust flavor from it. But I am definitely getting a vanilla, a chocolate, and a marshmallow. And I guess the vanilla comes from the marshmallow flavor. So, if you're ever anywhere, well, you can try it out. The 450 North S'mores Stack Stout. As you can see, it has a very beautiful dark tint with a little bit of head to it. A little bit of head and a whole lot of flavor. So, all of my drinkers across America, you're looking for a new stout to try. You know, if you're up north and it's cold, like I know it still is, because I'm from up there, man. I'm from north of Pittsburgh, and I know that it ain't getting warm no time soon. So, you want to hunker down in your favorite spot? You want to try a craft beer that is worthy of the weather? I recommend the Stacked S'mores from 450 North Brewing Company, Columbus, Indiana. And being from the north, they know that the stouts are the way to go in the wintertime. So, I'm going to go ahead and sign out for now, but not for long, because I'm going to be right back. I've still got two more. That's right, count them. Two more stouts of this flight of four. So, enjoy some 450 North S'mores Stack Stout. And when we come back, I'll be bringing the last two to you, the Drinking Across America fans. Until then, drink safe and have fun. You know I am. Salute to all my friends. Okay, all my fellow drinkers across America, joining me, the Ron Antinori, back at you for another episode of Drinking Across America, as I'm coming at you from the Noning Beer Bar and Kitchen in beautiful down uptown Columbus, Georgia, on Oberon Day. And I've already sampled the Oberon Wheat Ale and the new Mango Habanero Oberon. So now, I'm out trying some of the different beers that they've got here. You know, at Nonic, as you know, that's my favorite beer bar here in Columbus, Georgia. They always running about 30 different beers on draft at any given time. So, this third beer on my flight of four this afternoon is coming at us from, oh man, where is it coming from? Carton Brewing. Okay, it comes from Carton Brewing Company out of Atlantic Highlands, New Jersey. Okay, it's a new brewery to me. It may not be new to some of you, especially those up in the New Jersey, New York, Pennsylvania area, you know, up in the Northeast. You may know all about this brewing company. This is the first beer I've ever had from them, so I'm not too familiar with it. But what I do know is that it is a high-gravity golden coffee ale. And as you can see, it does have a very, very light golden color to it, almost luminescent. You can see through it, it's very light, it's very golden. It looks like it's gonna be a very kind of smooth beer, but I'm not sure. I mean, looks can be deceiving. So, it is a golden coffee cream ale with a milk and two sugar finish style. And it comes in at a pretty whopping 12% ABV. 12%, man. You think about it. That is 3 Budweisers. 3 Bud Lights. 3 of any of the big 3 breweries. Because their beers are averaging about 4 to 4.5% alcohol by volume. But this is definitely not your daddy's beer. Coming in at 12% alcohol, this is something that you definitely want to sip, because there's no way, unless you're a true alcoholic, that you're going to be able to down these beers by sucking them down like you do the Bud Lights, Mick Ultras, and all the same. But we're going to go ahead and we're going to give it a little taste test. We're going to let you know what we think of it here at Drinking Across America. Yeah. It does have a coffee scent to it, even though it is very light. It doesn't look like it would be a coffee stout, so to speak. As you can see, it's very light, very golden, kind of translucent. So that does not normally lead one to believe that it's a stout, especially a coffee stout. So, that being said, it does have the coffee scent to it. That's about all that I'm getting out of it, is a coffee scent. But we're going to go ahead and we're going to give it the old taste test, because that's the only way that we know if we're going to like a beer or not, and whether you like it or not. So, if you got a chance to try this coffee stout, this milk coffee stout, golden coffee cream stout, try it. Let me know what you think. Because right now, I'm about to let you know what I think of it. Very high coffee scent. So I'm expecting a lot of coffee, not only on the back taste, but in the taste itself. So let's go ahead and see what it tastes like, guys and gals, because I don't want you being left out. definitely a very coffee-forward beer. For being light-colored like it is, you would not expect it to come off with such a coffee, a strong coffee taste. It definitely does. When they say that this is a coffee stout, it definitely is. It comes in, you know, like I said, 12% ABV. That's very high for any kind of beer. I mean, if you're looking at the average ABV being, you know, 5, 6, 7%, which is, you know, that's about right for a drinking beer. When you start getting to 10% or more in the ABVs, to me, it gets more like a true sipping beer. It's something that you don't want to drink a pint of. I mean, I don't know anyone that would be able to drink 16 ounces of this and be able to, like, hey, give me another one. It's not going to happen. You know? And I'm a beer drinking professional. I'm not going to drink two or three of these in a 16-ounce pint. I'm going to drink maybe one as a pint, and then I'm going to be able to, you know, slow down a little bit. You want to definitely sip it. You want to enjoy the flavors. It has a lot of coffee flavor to it, so it's definitely a pick-me-up beer as well. So people that like to drink, you know, vodka Red Bulls because it gives them the alcohol and it gives them a little pick-me-up to where they don't have to worry about being overly intoxicated from drinking the beers. You can definitely do the same with this beer right here as you can with a vodka Red Bull. This is a beer that, even though it is 12% alcohol by volume, it doesn't come across as being that high. You definitely get the coffee taste, and the coffee taste is what will keep you awake. So, if you want to try some beers, you want to try some new beers, this is one of the leftover beers. That's one of the leftover beers from that right there. The juice strikes back. So, try it if you've got a chance before it's gone here at Noni Beer Bar and Kitchen. Okay, all my fellow drinkers across America, joining me at Drinking Across America here from Noonick Beer Bar and Kitchen in beautiful uptown Columbus, Georgia. We are here on March 25th, which is Oberon Day, and I've already tried out the Oberon beers, so I'm coming at you with a couple of the beers that are left over from the Juice Strikes Back Day, last Friday night here at Noonick. So, the next beer on the flight of four is from Imprint Beer Company, and this is the Black Forest Cake. It's a stout brewed with cherries and dark chocolate. Comes in at a pretty whopping 9.6% ABV, so it is definitely not a chugging beer. This is one that you definitely want to sip. As you can see, it's got a nice little dark coloring to it, a nice clear little brown head. And from the flavor, from what I'm smelling, you can definitely smell the cherries in it. It's a Black Forest cake, so it's going to taste like a German chocolate cake with cherries involved in it. It's definitely got both the black chocolate, dark chocolate, and cherry scent. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to give the ultimate taste test, which is what all of you are very interested in, knowing what the beer actually tastes like. And like I said, it comes in at a 9.6 ABV, so it is pretty high on the scale. Definite cherry flavors. A lot of cherry flavors. And they actually overpower the chocolate cake taste. But you do taste the chocolate on the after side, which is a good thing. I mean, you're actually wanting to a Black Forest cake is cherry and chocolate.
So the first thing you're going to taste is going to be the cherry, because cherry is more predominant than chocolate. Whenever you blend the two together, you're going to get the cherry over the chocolate every day. For 12% ABV, a definite 2 pints up on this beer right here. So you want to try it out? Go ahead and check it out, man. Imprint Beer Company. They're out of Pennsylvania, which is my home state. So, if you haven't had a chance to try them out, this is my first beer from the Imprint Beer Company. I do like, I mean, I've always been a stout fan. I've always been a porter fan. I like those darker, more full-bodied, flavorful beers. I got away from drinking them a lot for 2 years when I was down in West Palm Beach, because stouts and porters, as everybody knows, they're brewed more for wintertime, fall, for the colder weather. You don't want to drink a lot of them when you live in 80, 90 degree weather year-round, because they're just too heavy. They sit too heavy on the body. They're good to keep you warm in the wintertime and in the fall. But as far as trying to drink them when it's summer, when it's spring, when it's, you know, when it's 70, 80 degrees outside like it is right now here in Columbus, Georgia, you definitely don't want to drink more than maybe a taste of these. And by a taste, I mean a 4-ounce flight. So if you're anything like me and you like the flights instead of pints, check out some of your favorite stouts at your favorite beer bars. And I would recommend the Black Forest cake. Lots of chocolate flavor, lots of cherry flavors at the beginning, followed by a chocolate aftertaste. It goes down smooth, deceptively strong at 12% ABV. So keep that in mind when you're checking it out there, guys and gals. All across America, you're drinking, you're thinking, you're enjoying the good beers that we offer here. So, until next time, bottoms up, salute, and enjoy your beer. Until next time, I'm going to join you drinking across America.